Hello, good and fans. This is Prime 92, and today I'll be looking at the 144 high grade Grimgerde from the first season of Iron Blooded Orphans. This is a model that's taken me quite a while to get. It's second season's already over, and I finally got this model and built it. And I do regret not getting it sooner, because this thing is a glorious kit. It was actually after I got the I already forgot what it was called. The one that came after it was built from the frame, Helmwig, wasn't it? But yeah, using the Valkyrie frame, and yeah, made me want to get this thing. Now, it does have the same kind of flaw as the other one, where the visor is omitted and you just see the sticker monowire underneath. Really don't understand why they do that, because I've seen them use clear plastic before that are pretty small. And I think the weird red wine color is kind of messing up the camera color this on my viewfinder. We also have a metallic blue sticker for a camera in there, which is kind of weird. It's weird. I like the head because it gives the illusion that this could be like the top of the head, and then this is like the neck, kind of the grill part, or this is like an entire headpiece and this is the mouth. I just really like how it looks. Now, besides those two stickers, you don't actually have anything else on the body, which is really good. So everything here is plastic. These hoses hold pretty well. I like the added thrusters here on the back. Yeah, I really love the overall design, and I like the bulky shoulders here. Compared to like, it's bulkier at the waist, and a little bulkier in the, or bulkier in the shoulders and the waist. He's got kind of thin arms and legs, which I think looks pretty good. But yeah, that head just really does it for me. I really like it. And it holds together just fine. So did the other one, the Helmwig. So, and I like just two pieces of, like, white. Which is, it's very little, but you know what? It works. This thing just, I just really like it. Now the head is double ball jointed at the neck, so it's pretty good. You can easily get over that grill part of the head. And the arms, you can pull them out at the torso, so you can get some forward and back. And then you've got the polycap and the shoulder, or connected to the shoulder, so you can get some good up and down. And then the ball joint shoulder itself. Shoulder armor is hinged, your arm can go that far out altogether. Rotate below the shoulder. One joint at the elbow, it's still very good, pretty much double jointed. I mean, it looks like it. And you've got, it is double jointed, my bad. I was thinking of the gun frame, this one is double jointed here, and here, yep. Ball joint wrist, a nice tight ab crunch. You've got thrusters that can move in the back. You got the ball jointed waist. You've got the ball jointed, I guess they're side skirts. Legs go forward and back some. And out, if you get the armor here kind of out of the way, it helps about that far. Rotates at the thigh. You got a double jointed knee with a nice separation in the armor. And then you have the ball jointed ankle armor on the front. Oops. And you got a hinge for the ankle itself and a ball jointed foot. So it does have pretty good articulation. You can get some nice poses, and once again, that tight ab crunch definitely helps. I can never get the gun frames to hold that well, like, they're two halves, like, to hold the spine together. And I always find if you move it too much, it separates, where this one doesn't have that problem. Because it's a lot like the Greys. So yeah, good articulation. Now, it does come with a gun, which is probably just called a rifle. Actually, does it say it on the instructions? It's not in English, so it might... Nah, it's not English crap. Well, whatever. It's a gun. It's probably just called a machine gun. And it looks kind of different. You got a movable handle here. You got a peg, so you can store it on the back skirt. Like so, which is why the ammo drum is here on the side. And then you can unclip that and peg it onto the top for use. And it just feeds into the hand. Like that. Very easy. Now, someone mentioned this was used when it was first introduced. I don't remember. I mean, it rarely was. If it had been used at all, might have been used once. Because he has these really cool shields, which that's where the other stickers come into play. Just these round pieces here. Well, they could have put a piece of plastic in there, but I understand why they didn't. So it's not a huge deal, really. And so you just have to peg these onto the holes in the arms. Like so. And then you get the two swords. You can see where the, they were inspired from the Bale. I actually bring in Bale swords. You can see they are very similar, actually. Same color, but they are molded. The handles are molded differently. The blades are shorter. They're about the same thickness. Like, the detail is all kind of there. Like, this one, the Bale one actually looks like it was flattened compared to the, Grimgerde's. So they have the rounded handle as well. They can just go into the hand very nicely. Or, what I really love about the Grimgerde is the blades can go into the shields. Just pay one like that. They can be used like that offensively, or they can be stored just by flipping them around. Like that. And it's not a super big peg, so you can't really see it that much. So it doesn't stand out. And I just love it. I want to get the 100. Anyone who has it, tell me, do these rotate on the 100, like when they're storing the shields? Because I loved when McGillis was just standing there talking with Galio and just flipping these back and forth. Like, I wish this kit came with open hands. It doesn't. I wish it did, just because he was always, like, nonchalant with the Grimgerde. Just standing there, flipping the blades up while he was monologuing. Ah, so good. So yeah, I like the accessories. Pretty nice. So let's compare this with the next version of the Valkyrie frame we saw. Is it the Reinhardt Helmwig, I think? And, I mean, with the inner frame is the same, but that different armor is just, like, you can tell because of the gray pieces here. And it is the same, but that armor is so different. I mean, they're just completely different looking. The arms are similar, but even they are designed differently, but they have the same kind of, like, even the same kind of connection points in the arms, right there. But no, completely different. And I like that. And then, of course, we have the Bale, which, seriously, McGillis should have taken the shields from here and placed them on here. Just something, because he needed some defense besides just blocking with those swords. Like, I'm going to block like this for 10 minutes. Nothing will happen to these blades. Yeah. Tell that to a drill knee. So, yeah. I definitely liked the Grimgerde. Like, not just because of the performance of it in the show, but because I just love the way it looks. I love the head. I love the colors. I love the way the weapons are integrated into the shields. Yeah, everything about it is just pretty great. And it makes me want to get the 100 version. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.